All right, guys, we are live. Let me get the break screen off here. Okay, let's see, where are we? Okay, yeah, we are live. I am with Forgotten Millennials. What's up, sir?
How you doing today?
Good. So basically, we're going to go over your documentary that you just put out. And so I guess give a little background on it.
Yeah, so recently I've been to California, down in LA, both in Beverly Hills, did interviews there, and also did interviews out in Skid Row. I talked to a lot of the homeless people there, they migrate there just from far and wide because they provide all these free services. And I just wanted to kind of, you know, follow up with my own video, like a full form documentary type video, where, you know, how the state got from red to blue, and on top of that, how the illegal immigration crisis gets so large, and why is the homeless population the way that it is.
Okay.
So I basically compiled for a 10-minute video on how, that all happened, and everything sourced, and we're actually going to go over also a Pew Research interactive map to show illegal immigrants by population, for what's accounted for, at least, by state.
Okay. Cool. All right, so if there's nothing else you want to add, we can start this. It's called California Screamin'.
Mm-hmm.
All right, let's go here.
You got it.
This is cool. I like this opening.
Thank you. California Screamin'. Feel free to interject at any time.
Okay. This is all footage you shot?
Well, not all the footage. So this footage right here, this guy's name is Bam. Okay. I actually saw him because a lot of these guys are on drugs. So I was talking to cops while I was down there, right? And a lot of the cops are telling me that they kind of lose their minds because they have all these tents out there and they're doing drug deals inside the tents.
Okay.
The way California treats the tents is that they treat them like residences, so they need they need warrants to go into the tents, and they're happening so quickly that it can't be stopped. And then they can't stop and frisk when they probably know that someone just did a drug deal. They're pretty much stifled from doing their jobs. It's insane. So this guy, Bam, he's a multi-time felon. You can actually see, you guys can see the full interview of this on my channel. He's a multi-time felon. He's got almost a third strike on his head. And that's me on the right side. And he basically was just fixing a bike. And a bike is kind of like fallout. It's pretty insane. They actually fix bikes, repair bikes, trade parts. They barter for wealth down in this place. So this guy was fixing up a bike. I'm like, he's probably not on some heavy drugs because he's actually working on something. Let me go talk to him. So that's, a lot of this is my, a good amount of this is my footage. And then some of it's from drone footage I was able to capture, some from news footage, people around.
Cool.
That
kind of thing. Was that San Francisco?
Yes, it is San Francisco, and that is known as the Poop Patrol.
Yeah, I was wondering. I imagine they were cleaning up shit. That's okay.
And guys, they get paid $180,000 a year each.
Wow.
To
spray water on the shit. Sidewalk.
Yep. It's to spray off shit. And I actually have some quotes from Fox. They were actually going over the numbers. It's pretty staggering. But, $180,000 doesn't even buy you a house nowadays in L.A. So.
Oh, right. Yeah.
Oh, Oh, here's a quick tidbit.
Is that a bottle of piss?
Yeah, bottle of piss. And that guy cleaning up those bathrooms, they actually, so the mob, it actually went to crime activity quite a bit when they had these public bathrooms installed, because these public bathrooms would actually, you know, help the homeless, but obviously it went to criminal activity and people would actually, you know, hold people ransom. They would charge them to use the bathroom, even though it was a free facility. It went to crime extremely quick, and you'll find a lot of this type of stuff out in places like Skid Row and other places in the United States and third world, for to be honest. Just crime run rampant.
Jesus.
It's happened. California going from red to blue. How did it happen? It's an interesting thing. We haven't seen many other states go through this type of radical change before. So how is this affecting California? And what brought us to modern day? Homelessness, crime, all on the rise, illegal immigration. It's a mess. Today we're going to talk about how it got this way. So it all starts after World War II. The economy steadily grew after World War II, and the electorate's attention turned overseas to the Soviet Union and the expansion of communism. Republicans nominated moderate candidates who were strong anti-communists, leading Dwight Eisenhower and Richard Nixon to win California. Though Nixon lost the presidency to John F. Kennedy, the party's momentum was halted by Barry Goldwater, whose views on communism and fiscal conservatism were deemed too extreme. Then came Nixon. Born in Yorba Linda, represented California in both the House and Senate before becoming Vice President. He won his presidential campaign in 1968. After pledging to improve the economy and bring new leadership to the Vietnam War, he won re-election in a landslide against a liberal Democrat. After Nixon's 1974 resignation, Gerald Ford won California but lost the election. Then came the Reagan Revolution. Now, quick reference.
Carter. Sure.
So, Reagan, I think, was the main cause of, you know, not only the amnesty, but they had to, because he was trying to push for employers at the time to not hire illegal immigrants, but he had to cut a deal with the Democrats to have amnesty. And this is kind of what we're seeing today with the amnesty with Trump, what they're trying to make him do right now. So, I think there's a lot of, you know, parallel things that are happening here. And I just hope he doesn't pull the trigger. I mean, this will change demographics for many, many years to come. It might just ruin the entire electoral process, to be honest.
Yeah, well, like, if he gives some sort of amnesty, I think he offered, like, was it with DACA, like, for $2 million or something like that? And so, of course, that's going to come with those people would be legally allowed to vote. Of course, I mean, I don't think that stops Democrats. I think there is a big problem with the illegal voting. I wonder why are they campaigning in Mexico? That doesn't make any fucking sense why they would campaign in Mexico.
Yeah, and I don't think any other country campaigns in another country for a presidential campaign. That's just me. And they also, it's kind of ridiculous that, you know, the Democrats are trying to put Trump into a corner that is just based around, well, I'm kind of losing my head a little bit. So I think there's about 26 states that do not have illegal voting laws in place. I know Virginia is one of them that does have strict illegal voting laws. They do check for IDs, but voter ID laws are not even pushed in Texas, which is a huge place to have them done. It's run rampant. It's just not, there's so, like, half the states in the United States do not push for this at all. They don't, I have to go to a school board right? If I want to go to my kid's school board and vote for them, I have to show an ID. But for the president of the United States, I don't have to do that at all. It makes no sense.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Faced a tough road to re-election after the first term that saw oil crisis, slow economic growth, and the Iran hostage affair. Ronald Reagan, who as former governor was already popular in California, campaigned on a platform of returning optimism back to the country and easily won both campaigns. His popularity helped his successor, George H.W. Bush, win in 1988, the last time a Republican would carry California. Then we started to see Democrats surge in the state. California's Latino and Asian populations boomed in the 1990s. The growing segment of voters were turned off by Republican Party's hardline stance on immigration. After the party closely tied itself to Proposition 187, a controversial California ballot measure that denied public services to people in the country illegally, Republicans struggled to win back the state's immigrant population. Democratic candidates have won decisively in every election since 1992 by performing well in the most populous areas. Despite failing to win the presidency, Hillary Clinton won a higher percentage of votes than any candidate since Franklin Delano Roosevelt. Now that we've gotten the main history out of the way as to how the Democrats took power over the Republicans in California, let's dive deeper into how Republicans facilitated these changes and how illegal immigration has run rampant. The Immigration Reform and Control Act altered U.S. immigration law, making it illegal to knowingly hire illegal immigrants and establishing financial and other penalties for companies that employed illegal immigrants. The act also legalized most illegal immigrants who have arrived in the country prior to January 1st, 1982. Despite the passage of the act, the number of illegal immigrants in the United States rose from 5 million in 1986 to 11.1 million in 2013. This act was signed by Ronald Reagan on November 6, 1986. The state of California holds the fifth of the U.S. illegal immigrant population.
Estimating. So this is part of the interactive map that we could be going over later.
Okay, cool.
The fifth illegal population in one state.
That's insane. That's fucking crazy.
It's not million.
In the 1980s, local governments enacted sanctuary cities. The specific name sanctuary cities comes from the 1980s protests against federal immigration policies that denied asylum to refugees from El Salvador and Guatemala. San Francisco led the way by passing a city ordinance in 1985 that specifically forbade city police or civil magistrates from assisting federal immigration officers. Other cities followed suit. So too did organizations not licensed by the state, like churches. More recently, sanctuary cities have pushed back against aggressive federal deportation under George W. Bush and Barack Obama. There are more than 300 jurisdictions, cities, and counties.
Pause it right here.
Sure.
So these are all of the sanctuary cities, counties, and states.
Jesus Christ.
North Dakota is actually a sanctuary state, which is pretty insane. You know, obviously, Long Island, where I'm from, it's an absolute fucking mess. You know, I'm actually in Colorado right now. We're a hotbed. You know, where I'm at is not necessarily a hotbed, which is good. It's kind of a bubble.
Yeah.
Yeah, California, it's all over the place. I mean, I'm surprised Northern California gets hit as much as it does. But, yeah, it just goes all – Washington, they have a unique homeless problem. And I'm not sure if I've told this on your stream before. They have an RV problem. So you have RVs lining the streets in Seattle, Washington, and basically they just take up all the room in the streets. They're not technically homeless. They are living in their vehicles, and they're all run down. They're all ridiculous. You know, Florida, I think, just passed, if I'm correct, sanctuary city law where they're not going to allow them anymore. Is that true? I think they did.
I'm not sure about that. This is crazy, though. Like, there's this many sanctuary cities
There's a map. So the yellows county. So the yellows are counties. It's by county, city, and state. So a lot of people don't know that. So that's why
I didn't even know there were sanctuary counties.
Right, right. So it's absolutely insane. Like, at least the sanctuary cities, especially where I'm at in Colorado, they're mostly confined to counties. So the local elections are key there. You know, it's not on a federal level or anything like that. The cities are all over New York. They're all over California. New Mexico's got them. Texas, thankfully, doesn't have them. They have, like, one county, but it's still rampant because they have the border right there that kind of have to push up. But, yeah, North Dakota being a sanctuary state, I mean, you can see how Minnesota gets flooded. We talked about, you know, I know you've talked about on your channel, and a lot of people have talked about Somalis.
Yeah.
Constantly flooding Minnesota. Ilhan Omar State, I mean, it makes sense. You know, and it's just to see the map of everything in front of you, like when I was doing my research on this, it was kind of astounding. So there's a lot more counties and cities, and I think this is a little bit older. I think it's about from like 2015. Yeah, 2015. So this is obviously grown since then, and now they're kind of drawing back. So I think Florida is cleaning it up as of right now.
So they basically, so it looks like Democrats worked for them in California. They're just trying to do to the rest of the country. That seems to be ultimately what's going on here.
No, yeah, that they want. Well, all Californians want to push all of their same thing with New York. Because I'm from New York. I mean, I understand that. All of them want to push their, you know, values onto everyone else, especially Texas. Texas is going to be a huge battleground, guys, coming up in the next election and elections after that. You know, you guys got to go out and vote. It's, you know, we've got a lot of people talking to the president, I think, tomorrow on internet censorship. Scott Pressler, I couldn't believe it. Scott Pressler was actually one of the people that got invited up there. We've talked about this extensively, so I may get a message to the president of the United States, which I'm very grateful for.
That's awesome.
Yeah, I mean, he didn't know much about this, and then when we were hanging out, basically I would tell him about everything that's happening. So, you know, him, Tim Pool, a bunch of other people are going up there. And hopefully we, you know, the censorship stops. I'm not really about government regulation of private businesses, but, you know, there's got to be a breaking point. I mean, Facebook just allowed, and I'm sure you went over this in your live stream, Murray. I'm not sure exactly if you covered this, but
yeah,
they're allowing calls for violence on people that have, the media has deemed to be problematic. So that's insane.
Yeah, we went over that. There's a lot of new changes coming in the month of July. So, yeah, they had that. And then now they said after there was enough outrage, they came out and said that it was imprecise, which is, you know, the tactic that they use. If enough people complain, they go, oh, that was a mistake. So, yeah, that was allowing calls for violence for people that they deemed unacceptable. You have the new Twitter dehumanization policy, which they claim you're not allowed to dehumanize religions. Now, of course, I doubt that's going to be applied to Christians. I imagine you'll be able to say whatever you want about Christians. And then YouTube with the new policy at the end of July, where you basically can't criticize people. If you make a video where the way they phrased it was like, if you embarrass someone or one person is like the sole person being criticized, that it's basically hate speech. So this shit is about to get really fucking crazy.
Right. And guys, I do not monetize my channel. I'm incapable of monetizing it. I've had video, emails from YouTube already, proactive emails from YouTube telling me that it wouldn't. I have problematic content. I get 3 copyright strikes a video.
Jesus.
It's insane. I love making videos, and that's what I love doing. So I love you guys to, you know, subscribe, chill out as much as possible.
No, it's understandable. You know, yeah, it's very difficult right now, especially for newer people.
Right, right. I joined the platform in the height of this. You know what I mean? Like, Trump became president, and I'm like, you know, I'll make a channel, screw it.
Yeah.
And, you know, I make memes. I make these types of things, more informative videos. I'm kind of all over the map. I try to, you know, I obviously can't make everyone happy on each video, but,
sure,
you know,
sure.
It's something. Like, it depends on if I'm watching something at the time, you know, I'll make a meme out of it. I make a lot of Alex Jones memes. I have very successful videos in some respects. You know, it's fun. I enjoy doing it. It's a passion project. And, you know, again, thanks for having me on. Cause
yeah, anytime.
Words like yours, you know, they're important, especially with the name Hard Bastard. You are getting it for all ends, my friend. Like,
yeah, I can't imagine doing a newer YouTube channel under the circumstances. You get completely buried. It's, I mean, people like Styx are getting buried. Like, they're fucking with his views. He's got a big channel, and this is hopefully this ends at some point. I think it only ends when we move to alt tech and there's finally enough people on there. I really don't expect YouTube or Facebook to do anything. I hope that the summit works and there's some sort of progress, but I mean, this is like an information war, and they don't look like they're stopping anytime soon.
No, and this is World War III. It's a war on information. It's a war on your mind. That's what it is. It's a war on who's putting the right content out at the right times. I mean, we have people calling for censorship on all sides. I mean, you have the Koch brothers working with George Soros because they're multi-billionaires. They would have every advantage for the internet being censored on both ends.
Yeah.
It's a mess. It's a mess. They have guerrilla warfare in this because you don't know what the sides are. You don't know what's going on. And there's no one wants violence. No one wants to commit violence. No one wants this. It's a war of words, you know, and they are not allowing the valve to be released. And
yeah.
That's the problem here. That's the problem.
Yep, absolutely.
That withhold cooperation from federal immigration officers today. With the creation of sanctuary cities, we've seen the increase of homelessness throughout the nation, especially in California. Due to the mild climate and very comfortable living conditions, homelessness has thrived in California, in San Francisco, and in LA. The streets are being paved with all types of waste, from needles to feces, to the point where the government has hired a poop patrol to deal with the issue.
Jesus.
The poop patrol consists of 6 members, each of which is paid $100,000 plus per year to deal with the poop problem in San Francisco.
Getting paid $185,000 a person. Their one mission
is
to clean up poop on the streets.
How much money? How much money are they paid?
$185,000 a person, Jason. All they do is pick up poop.
Hopefully soon, California will turn around and realize that their homeless problem, their poverty problem, their crime problem, their illegal immigration problem has gotten too great, and they will start to move in the other direction and hopefully be the state it once was. We'll find out soon enough. I appreciate you all for watching. This is Tim for Forgotten Millennials, and this is what happened to California. If you enjoyed the content, please consider subscribing to my channel, and also follow me on other social media platforms. I'm on Twitter, Gab, Minds, and BitChute. Have a good day.
And there you go, ladies and gentlemen.
Cool. Now, you want to go over this chart? Should I click the link in the
Let's click the link.
Description here and see what happens. Okay.
You can kind of go by state, and we'll show the audience how, you know, from Pew Research, how much illegal immigrants are in each state, you know, that the ones that are counted, you know, that's why the census is so important. We need to get that question on the census. That's key. We need to get these people shown in order to vote. Like, that's the key figure here.
All right. So you have the list here. It says,
are you pulling it up? Cause I'm not seeing it on my end.
Oh, does this do? Oh, hold on a second. This also does website links? I can bring it up here.
I have it in the chat right now, so that should show up.
Oh yeah, browser extension required. That's weird. Yeah, I didn't think this did.
Well, it gives you the, you want to install it.
I think it's for this. Is the browser extension for this thing though? Yeah, let me bring it up. I have it up on screen here. So is there specific states you want to look at, or you want to just want me to like read some of these off?
No, obviously we could do California, New York, Florida as it stands right now, because they might have signed that out. So we might see how many will be gone. And also they might, you know, be doing 1 or 2 million illegal immigrants they might be shipping out of the country very soon. Hopefully they actually hold true on that. It's tough to say because they keep backpedaling on this stuff. So I really don't know what's going to happen with them.
So yeah, California, 2.2 million. New York, 725,000. Texas, 1.6 million. Let's see if there's anyone else in the Florida, 775,000, I think.
And guys, this is all Pew Research, by the way, that are linked in the description on the video itself. You guys can check it out. You can use it for a reference. It is Pew Research. It's a good source. Go for it.
Pennsylvania, 170,000. Illinois and Georgia, 400,000. Alaska, 5,000. Who has the lowest? Let's see. Alaska, Montana, South Dakota, North Dakota, or no, less than five. Vermont.
Montana doesn't play.
Wow. West Virginia, less than 5,000.
Yeah, and that's accounted for, guys. I mean, think about this. The illegal immigrants, a lot of them aren't even known to the United States government. Like, we're talking minimal. I don't even know how Pew Research really got these numbers together. They did. It's astounding how they're able to get this amount. But we're talking, this is probably an older study from 2015. We're talking, yeah, that chart was from 2015, so it's definitely risen by then. You know, more, I would say, in a couple hundred thousand in each state. Especially when it's been up so much in the Trump administration because of all the, you know, media around it. So we're seeing much larger numbers this time around.
Man. Yeah, I don't know what the actual number could possibly be. Yeah, I don't see how this ends well. I mean, there's absolutely no willingness to resolve the issue. You have Democrats that are arguing for policies that are going to make the issue like worse. The word worse doesn't even define what they're attempting to do here. This is just to have complete open borders. Is absolutely insane. This is I really don't know. I mean, fortunately, Trump is in office, and it's unlikely they're going to get their way. But I also don't see any progress happening. So it's like the problem's going to keep getting worse.
Yeah, and I mentioned in your stream before, you know, through Super Chat, that you know, Trump has gotten three times the amount of funding he did back in 2016. So I honestly don't think we're going to have to worry about him getting back into office. There's a much better, I mean, people didn't even know if he was going to be in it or not, or even be the front runner. We know he's there. We know he's running. We know he's the guy. So that's out of the question. And he's actually done a lot for the economy. The economy is a real big factor on if someone gets reelected or not. You know, we've got Epstein behind bars. We'll see what happens with that. Hopefully he actually talks about more pedophiles. We're seeing more stuff come out. Yeah. Is what people voted for when they voted for Trump in the first place. A cloth what the media was doing. I think that's why they voted for him in the first place. They knew that this guy was trying to call out the media that was trying to bring him down so much. And he's spiteful now. The gloves will come off next 4 years, and people know that. So a lot of things that, like Hillary for prison, hopefully that happens. I mean, through Epstein, who knows? But that kind of stuff you will see in the last 4 years, because he doesn't need to get reelected again. This guy can just go off. So we can see. We'll see what happens. I'm excited.
I think he'll probably get reelected. The other thing with, like, because it's difficult to tell how much is he talking shit to try to get some sort of deals done and how much is he's completely serious. But if he were to attempt to remove, you know, 500,000, 1 million illegals from the country, isn't that, I mean, when was the last time something like that was even suggested? That seems like it would be. He'd be like the only president that would have the balls to do something like that. And perhaps after that, if he does it, then you're going to get a much more conservative, like merit-based immigration system.
So a lot of this is optics. I think Obama was the last guy to actually do that, but he never announced it. He never talked about it because they don't need to. Trump likes to talk about it. He likes to talk, you know, grandstand and do these things.
Yeah.
And, you know, that's what, you know, a lot of people like about him. He's just upfront what he's going to do. And with our enemies, he's not upfront. I mean, that's basically what we're doing.
Yeah.
With Syria, North Korea, all that, you know, China. We're seeing all this happen in real time. I mean, he just crossed the DMZ, first president to ever do that.
Yeah.
It's fantastic. So he's got a lot of good optics on his side going into the 2020 election. You have Kamala Harris literally talking, going back to the 1970s on certain policies when they call themselves progressives. They want to go back and make, honestly, with this reparations argument, make white people hate black people for no apparent reason whatsoever. These people are evil. They don't want progression at all. They don't want any type of they're not anti-racist. They are racist. That's what they built their platform on their entire time. They built the divide. That's all they do. And they will just blame Trump for the divide. And it's hilarious. I'm just seeing Kamala Harris. The fact that Biden's going down in the polls and Kamala Harris is going up, it means they have absolutely no goddamn shot. Bernie Sanders just played the USSR theme song on his Twist account. Did you hear about this?
No. Are you serious?
Yeah, you can pull that up if you want. It was one of the Twitch fails. So his first Twitch live stream, guys, he puts the fucking USSR theme song. I guess some guy, some woke bay guy in there, fucking puts the USSR song.
And they cut the line.
Excuse the soundboard there.
It's okay. A 32-second video, and he put No, it was like they were waiting for him to come on, and they had like a cycle of patriotic music, and one of which was a little bit lower than the rest. And it was the USSR communist theme, guys. So that's it's hilarious.
See, that's ridiculous.
And it's getting pretty viral. I think H3 was actually talking about it on his podcast. That's what got it so much attention. So it's pretty funny. It's pretty funny how all this is turning out. Bernie's going to take in the polls. All that energy is going to go to Elizabeth Warren. I would think you'd probably think that too.
Like what's weird. So the debate happens and Harris gains on Biden. I went over an article tonight that Biden is now like back to gaining, which is insane. I don't understand how, even especially after that debacle of a debate, he still looks strong, which is nuts. The guy, he's arguably a pedophile with the hair sniffing and shit.
I mean, Trump hasn't even debated Biden yet, dude. I'm gonna get popcorn. I'm gonna get beer. I'm gonna have parties. I'm gonna have people watching this stuff just laughing their ass off.
That would be great.
It's hilarious. We should do a live stream. We should do a live stream during the debate. Like that's it's gonna be absolutely hilarious when Trump like steamrolls him. I don't even know, man. Like it's gonna be how he doesn't bring up the videos.
I don't see how he doesn't bring up the videos. There's no way he's not bringing that up.
Yeah, no, he's got way too much baggage. I mean, even Kamala Harris had baggage. She's not even black. She's South Pacific and Jamaican.
Yeah. Did you see? So they said, I think they tried to argue that Mitch McConnell was against reparations. And then they're like, oh, we found out that like his family was slave owners or whatever. And so he comes out and he's like, totally trolling them, like, yeah, well, you know, it's good to see that, like, I have something in common with Barack Obama. We're both against reparations, and we both had family that were slave owners. And, of course, during all this, they completely omit the fact that Kamala Harris's family owned slaves as well.
Right, and her father confirmed that, guys. Her father is the source of this information. So, yeah,
she's doomed.
I don't know. Like, these people lie about their race. You got two people in the main square, Elizabeth Warren and Kamala Harris lying about their race, basically Rachel Dolezal 2.0. Yeah. You got people calling for open borders, which is Beto O'Rourke and Cory Booker. I mean, basically Cory Booker being a coyote. He's actually
he helped people come across. That was incredible.
Yeah, it's astounding. Like they are literally helping foreign powers and talking about foreign interference in our elections. Where we have people at home, our own companies, Twitter, Facebook, every social media platform, completely coming out on video and saying, we're going to be changing these elections. We're going to be changing the information that people can see. It's outrageous, and I hope everything will turn around soon.
Oh, yeah. So Wikipedia and Google are starting to scrub references or anything related to Bill Clinton and Jeffrey Epstein together. Unbelievable.
Oh, I remember you. I was actually watching your live stream when I forgot which newscaster said it, but he was like, crap. He was saying,
Lawrence O'Donnell.
What was it?
Lawrence O'Donnell.
Yeah, Lawrence O'Donnell's like, oh, yeah, we're reading this crap. Like, he doesn't believe it. They don't believe it. It's hilarious. They got Freudian slips all over the place.
Yeah.
They're cowering. And the fact that CNN came out and talked against Antifa for 30 seconds, I find it hilarious. I'm actually going to make probably a comp of the times both Brian Stelter and Chris Cuomo talked about, and this is a quote from Chris Cuomo, what you're about is wrong and fighting you is right.
Yeah.
Talked about Antifa constantly fighting against whoever is against them. Like, screw the neo-Nazi argument. Like, they're right. Talking about anybody.
Yeah.
That is for the country, for borders, anything like that. I mean, I recently saw a DC protest. I don't even think they were Antifa. They were just straight up communists, like holding arm in arm. Just,
yeah.
I'm not sure if you saw that, dude.
Yeah.
People were attacked. Like, they were burning the flag. They were doing all that. And guys, it's actually interesting because it's a crime to burn the gay pride flag, but not the American flag.
Oh, yeah. I was reading about that. They're going to charge a dude, or they're looking into charging a dude with a hate crime for burning the pride flag.
And I don't agree with the flag burning thing. Like, I do think people should be able to talk against their government,
sure,
you know, for the real. But honestly, I understand the gay pride flag argument. But like, why do they need a flag? I mean, I'm friends with plenty of gay people. They say the same thing. Why do we need a flag? We're not a nation.
You should be able to burn anyone's flag. So that's some crazy bullshit.
Exactly. So, you know, they can spin it as much as they want. It'll go to the Supreme Court. Supreme Court stacks, so we'll see what happens. But, you know, RGB's on stilts at this point. So we'll see. Weekend at Bernie's again.
How hard is it to provide one piece of video of her walking around? I just want one.
She's always sitting. She's always sitting. It's like she's a puppet. It's hilarious.
Oh, my God.
And focus, man.
Absolutely. Yeah, but,
you know, again... Again, man, thanks for having me on. It's always been a pleasure to, you know, come on your program, talk to your audience. A lot of your audience is mine.
Absolutely.
You know, and guys, keep subbing, keep commenting. It helps me in the algorithm. You know, like me and Harbass were talking about, the censorship's real. I get copyright strikes while I'm uploading videos from Jesus China, Christ. From anybody. Like, it's live. So, again, I don't make money on these videos. I do it out of love and, you know, passion for what I like. And, you know, I love coming on and speaking my truth. So that's, you know, that's how I am.
Yeah, dude, anytime, man. I appreciate it. It's very difficult for newer YouTubers now because it's so incredibly stacked against you. So yeah, dude, anytime. Keep me posted on future projects and shit. And we'll have you on again, dude.
You got it, man. Anytime.
All right, man. Have a good one.
Have a good night, man.
All right, take care. Thank you.